this is the transfer function window, and what happens here is you need a reference signal like this. You can see the microphone 1 is my microphone, that's the measurement microphone, and the microphone 4 or the channel 4 of that sound card is actually my reference input. Okay, so now this reference input will depend at what point you want the reference. Do you want the reference after the console? So there might be multiple reference points depending on your signal chain. So typically what I do is like I try to keep my sources similar. So for example, if I am generating the noise from the console, a console direct out or a matrix out or something, that signal generator where it is inducing the noise directly on that channel will be my reference. And then that same signal generator, that same noise, I will induce in a channel so that it comes through the master and the matrix and through the PA system. Okay, since the PA system will be connected to the masters of the console. So if I induce a pin noise in the channel, it will go through the entire processing of the board through the master and then come out of the PA system. And now when I have my microphone 1 connected in my channel 1, it is actually showing you that this is how it sounds in the ground in accordance with all the reflections and everything. And because you remember I have fed it with a reference signal where the pin noise is directly induced in that reference like a matrix or something, and it is not going via the master and all this thing, that means I am getting a flat response from the console. So now what the transfer function will do is like it will evaluate the signal like, okay, this is how it needs to be, like a flat response which my reference look like. But in the actual scenario when I have put my microphone, it actually doesn't look like that. Okay, and then it will evaluate like, okay, this particular frequency is much higher in the ground, whereas in the reference it is not that higher. So it will analyze it, average it out, and show you like, okay, this much decibel, this particular frequency is above or below the reference signal. So here what I will show you is like, you can see this is my first microphone position where you can see this is the data. Now you can see this red lining, this means disturbance, this is coherence, okay? Wherever this is less, this is great. Wherever it is more, that means you cannot trust that data. And this coherence will differ depending on different microphones. So like for example, this is my second microphone position. And now you can see this particular coherence at around 205. You can see it is not there in the first position. But in the first position, there is 257, which is not there in the second microphone position. Similarly, I go to the third microphone position and I see there are some things there, but this area is quite clean, whereas in the other area, this is clean. Now let us check this, like 1 kilohertz, you can see there is nothing in the second reading and there is nothing in the third reading. So basically these are different. So when we select all these three different microphone positions and right click and average, I get a data something like this. Now in this data you can see the coherence has reduced because it has analyzed all these three microphone positions and then came up with a data like, okay, these are the coherence that are constantly changing in all these three positions, so these are in relation to that particular position. So when I average them, they clean them up and only keep those coherence data which are consistent across all the three. Okay, so for example, let us check this. This is 4.22. Let us check here 4.22. Let us check again 4.2. Okay, there is coherence. And again, let us go here and 4.2. So this is consistent across the three microphone position. So in the average, it has shown in 4.22, there is a particular coherence or disturbance that is occurring in that particular value. So the more you take microphone positions and average, the more you get a cleaner data which you can trust. Now here I can see there's a much more lesser coherence. So this buildup of the low end is something I can trust. So similarly, I have taken all the subwoofers together because there was a center cluster as well. Now I can see this is my subwoofer and I can trust this data because the coherence is great here. Okay? For more videos like this, please like and share and subscribe to my channel. And you can always comment what is that you are looking for or what do you want to learn in the next video. If you want to talk smart, some more details, let me know. Thank you.